Good morning. I'm so glad you're joining us for chapel this morning. I hope everybody's having a good week and enjoying their spring break. Is it spring break?
Yes, it is.
So, well, we love chapel so much, we didn't want to stop chapel. So we're just doing chapel even though you're out for spring break. So I hope everybody's got their light and they've got their light up and they'll join us with this little light of mine.
Yes.
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands.
Me
mean people, so we're over on this side. Mean people made fun of Jesus and hurt him. They didn't believe he was really the king. They made him carry a heavy cross, and they made him wear a crown of sharp thorns. Jesus' disciples cried because they loved Jesus, and they didn't understand why Jesus was having to suffer all of this. The mean people marched Jesus to the top of a hill and put him on a cross. When Jesus died, the sky got dark. Jesus' friends took his body down from the cross and put it in a grave called a tomb, and they rolled a big, heavy stone in front of the tomb. Now we're over on this side. 3 days later, some women went to the tomb to take care of Jesus' body. When they arrived at the tomb, they couldn't believe their eyes. The huge stone had been rolled away. The women slowly walked inside the tomb. An angel was standing inside, and the angel said, "Don't be scared. You've come looking for Jesus, but he's not here anymore. Look for yourselves. Jesus is alive. He's risen from the dead. Go and tell his followers the good news." Pretty soon, other people met with Jesus. They were excited when they found out that Jesus was alive, and they told others that Jesus was risen from the dead. That's good news for us too, isn't it? That's why we celebrate Easter. Many people saw Jesus after he rose from the dead. Jesus told his followers to go everywhere in the world and tell people about him. Jesus said, "Teach all the people everywhere to believe in me. Tell them about the new life they can have. I'll send the Holy Spirit to help you. Remember that I'm with you always." And then Jesus rose up into the clouds and went back to heaven. To this very day, Jesus has kept his promise. He's with us every day, and he loves everyone very much. Jesus wants us to tell others about him, just as his disciples did. Who will you tell about Jesus' love? I love that story. The name of this book is called The Miracle of Easter. And that's what we celebrate. And we're going to celebrate Sunday morning will be Easter morning. And so even though we're at home, it's okay. You can celebrate Easter anywhere you are, because we are so happy that Jesus loves us so much. So bow your heads. We're going to say a prayer, and I want you to say the prayer after me, just like we do in chapel. Dear God.
Dear God.
Thank you.
Thank you.
For Jesus.
For Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you.
For loving us.
For loving us.
We love you.
We love you.
Amen.
Amen. We don't, believe it or not, we do not have any birthdays this week. Isn't that strange?
Birthdays.
All of our students, not one of them has a birthday this week. But you were talking about celebrating Easter at home. Do you think that the children can have Easter egg hunts at home?
I do think they can have Easter egg hunts at home.
With their families
with
at
their
home.
With their family, yes,
so
indeed.
So the Easter bunny can come.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, good, because I know some of the children might be worried that the Easter bunny might not be able to make it.
Oh, I'm sure the Easter bunny has this covered.
Good.
And we can celebrate, tell the story of Jesus.
Yes.
And know while we celebrate Easter, we can all do that at home with our families. It'll be a lot of fun.
Good.
A lot of fun.
Good.
All right, let's sing Jesus Loves Me.
Thank you.
list, and then I forgot what's on the list. Air five, Miss Debbie.
Air five.